Before God, I entered into a covenant to provide prayer for you every day from now until Jesus comes. You'll never be without prayer again. Take advantage of it.
Welcome to Morning Prayer.
Praise God and welcome to the Friday episode of Morning Prayer. My goodness, it's been one awesome week, hasn't it, Holden?
Amen. Yes, sir.
Amen. I'm John Jester. I'll be your host this morning, and I'm here with Holden Hanley. Holden, are you ready to pray?
I'm always ready to pray. You know, I can't think of a better way to start out the day than with prayer.
Amen. Amen. And I believe that you are going to receive a miraculous, supernatural download from the Lord this morning. I just have it in my spirit that every promise of God, everything that the Lord has promised is yours, and all it takes is the prayer of faith to grab hold of it. So whether that's healing, deliverance, whatever you need this morning, God's got it for you, and you can grab hold of it by faith. You can call the number 877-281-6297. I'm going to slow down and give it to you again. 877-281-6297. Our licensed prayer ministers are here. They're waiting on your call. They're waiting to come into agreement with you according to the Word of God in faith. They're trained in the Word of God, and they are ready to pray the prayer of faith with you. And speaking of our licensed prayer ministers, we have our good friend Tim Fox over in the aisle with our licensed prayer ministers this morning. Tim, you're looking good, first of all. What's going on, man?
Well, you're very kind. Thank you. I am in the midst of our prayer ministers, and they are waiting on you to give them a call at 877-281-6297 so they can pray and agree with you for whatever it is you're believing for, John.
Praise God. Well, we are excited about this morning. I want to tell you, I sense in my spirit this morning just an unction holding where the promises of God are concerned. Because there are over 7,000 promises in the Word of God. In 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 20 says this. This is in the New King James Bible. It says, "For all of the promises, not just some of them, but all of the promises of God are in Him. In Him are yes, and in Him amen, to the glory of God through us." So God's not on the fence about your promise. God's not on the fence about whether or not He wants to bless you. God's not on the fence about whether or not He wants to do something in your body to heal your body, to set you free. He has already made up His mind. All it takes from you is that amen, is that act of faith to take hold of those promises. And we've got some people who are taking hold of their promises already. Trina in New Bern is praying for healing and restoration for a friend's 93-year-old grandmother. Well, first of all, Trina, I'm praying that that grandmother would continue to live and live out the fullness of her days. And Father, right now, we pray for restoration of that 93-year-old grandmother. Lord, I thank You for those 93 wonderful years that You've blessed her with. And Father, I give You glory for the wonderful, miraculous, supernatural restoration of that grandmother in Jesus' name. Alice and Alliance is praying for debt freedom and for her business to be blessed. Well, I'm telling you, one of the promises of God is that you will not have to walk in poverty and you will not have to walk in debt. Every debt is paid for. So right now, Father, I thank You for debt freedom. And Lord, not just for Alice, but Father, for anyone who's listening, debt freedom right now in Jesus' name. God, I pray supernatural debt cancellation in the name of Jesus. Mary in Rialto, California says several friends of hers and her family need healing. Her uncle is in a hospital with diabetes, is in a coma. Her daughter had a stroke and needs a healing and restoration. Well, listen, Mary, I just want to take a moment and tell you this. When the devil shows his hand, God always shows a better hand.
Praise God.
When the devil shows his hand, God always shows a better hand. That's all the devil is doing, is he's trying to pile things up to get you discouraged. But I'm going to tell you that every promise in the Word of God belongs to you, and He says that you and your house will be saved, and that salvation includes healing. Father, right now, in Jesus' name, I thank You that Mary's family is being healed. That uncle, God, that daughter, right now, in Jesus' name, You're reversing the curse in their life. And Lord, I give You praise for it. I thank You according to Your word. And God, You're raising them up in the name of Jesus. The last one I have is Jacqueline in Aurora says her sister-in-law's brother needs healing in his kidneys and for her daughter's healing in her mouth bones. Mouth bones right now. Father, in Jesus' name, I thank You that You're healing her mouth bone, and God, that you're making those kidneys whole. They're functioning the way they're supposed to function, to the glory of Almighty God. And God, I thank you for raising her up in the name of Jesus. Amen. Holden, praise I see God. You standing there with a stack.
I do. Pastor, I love what you said. When the devil shows his hand, the Father always has a better
hand. That's absolutely
right. I want to read a couple better hands right now.
Glory to God.
Here's Phyllis from Wyoming. She bought tickets to go to Brazil. They couldn't get a hold of anyone to process their refund, so she got a text Friday that she would be getting a full refund, and it arrived on Monday.
Amen.
Thank God that you were paid in full.
Glory
Here's
to God.
Frances again from Orange, believing God. She says she's been discouraged, but she heard them say, rise up, and she felt something and rose up and claimed her healing today. Well, we claim it with you right now.
Praise
it's a
God.
Done deal. He has set healing before you through the stripes of Jesus, and we're in agreement with that right now in Jesus' name. Here's Leanne from London. After prayer on, she called in for prayer earlier this week, and after that, her husband got a job.
Glory to God.
Praise the Lord, Leanne. Thank you so much for calling and sharing that with us. And here's a couple prayer requests. Here's Gayla believing God for healing for her family. Your family is totally and completely healed from the crown of their head to the soles of their feet. Just you and your household shall be saved. A part of that saved in the Greek is healing. So Father, right now we thank you for healing manifesting in all of Gayla's family members in Jesus' name. Terry from Sun City Center believing God for healing for her pet dog Bailey. She's sick. Well, right now you and your livestock are blessed according to Deuteronomy chapter 28. So, Father, right now, I thank you for undergirding her pet, her dog right now, and manifesting the healing power in that dog's body in Jesus' name. Phyllis from Wyoming, believe in God for healing for husband's knee. Right now, just as a point of contact, I encourage you, lay your hand on your own knee and say, Father, my husband's knee is healed by Jesus' stripes. Amen. Amen. And last one, Karen from Brooklyn, believing God for healing for her cousins. Father, right now, we lift up Karen and her cousins to you, that you are manifesting the healing power of God that cast out all sickness, all infirmity, and all disease, and all that remains is the healing presence of the Master in Jesus' name.
Glory
Pastor John.
To God. Praise God. Hey, I want to go over to our aisle where Tim Fox is, over with our prayer ministers. Tim, what's the atmosphere like over there? What's going on? I hear a lot of praying and ringing in the background. What's going on over there?
Well, you know, these folks love to pray for people. They love to speak and pray the Word of God over people. And that's exactly what happens when you call 877-281-6297. You will get the Word of God spoken over you and prayed over you. And John, I do want to take a moment. The news did break overnight that the President and the First Lady tested positive for COVID. So I think it would be a good idea for all of us right now to pause and pray for our President, because listen, whether you like the guy or not, he's still our President. Whether you agree with him or not, he's still our President. So we are going to take a moment right now and we're going to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come to you right now on behalf of our President and First Lady. Father, we thank you that this diagnosis of COVID will not be a serious diagnosis. We curse the life force in COVID, and we say that this will be a quick and speedy recovery, Father God, and that he will be able to do everything that he needs to do to fulfill his duties as President of the United States. And Father, we thank you for any of his staff, any of the members of his cabinet, senators, House of Representatives. Father, we thank you that all of those folks are protected by the blood of Jesus, Father. And we thank you again for your healing power to flow through their bodies in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. That's a good thing to do. Now, let me read a couple of these prayer requests. Maria called in, prayer to find a home to move to and finances. Luis called in, healing for severe sinus infection, salvation for her husband. Crystal called in, debt cancellation. Crystal, we had a lot of those yesterday on morning prayer. I feel like there's a debt cancellation thing going on among our partners and friends. Shirley called in, healing from pain in her body. Bethel called in, healing for bladder, legs, and back, and family restoration. And Teresa called in family healing, and debt cancellation. John, back to you.
Hey, Tim, stay with me for just a second. I want to get Tim and I on the screen for a second, because we've got several people. What you just prayed for our president, we've got several people writing in here. Mike in Hollywood was praying for the president, for the president's protection and healing, and William is calling in praying for the president's healing. And I just want folks to know, you prayed a wonderful prayer, but there was something in that prayer that you said that I want to highlight. The president is a Christian. The president is a blood-bought believer, and he has the same promise of healing that you and I have as children of the Lord Most High. And I believe that he is going to raise up quickly, and this thing is going to leave his body, and it will be miraculous. Amen. I just wanted to keep you with me, Tim, because that prayer was so awesome.
Thank you, sir.
For our
Thank
president.
You.
Praise God. We want to get to some more of these prayer requests. Glenda in Kentucky is praying for healing for her shoulder and her spine. Julia in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania is praying for her son to be healed and to test for stress, to remove stress from him, and for the peace of God. Father, in Jesus' name, right now, I pray for the peace of God over that son. Lord, I thank you that God, that pile-up technique, that one thing after another, we come against it in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Father, that healing is springing up quickly in her son, in Jesus' name. Linda in Gadsden is praying for her eyesight to be restored. Well, Linda, I'm telling you, on this program, we've watched people's cataracts fall out of their eyes. We've watched people with cataracts have them just fall out in the sink. So right now, in Jesus' name, I thank you, Father, for healing Linda's eyesight. And God, you're raising Linda up right now in Jesus' name. Angela in Rayford is praying for protection and order. Father, I thank you that the protection of God belongs to us as children of God. Father, I thank you that you're protecting, and God, that order is coming, because order is your way. And so we give you glory for that. And Dolores in Waterford is praying for total and complete healing in her body and salvation for her children. Well, Dolores, let me tell you something. The Lord promises you your children. The Lord says that you and your house will be saved. And so, Father, right now I'm praying that you would send laborers into the lives of Dolores' children. God, that you would put them in their lives, Father, and that they would minister the gospel to them. And Father, we pray for salvation quickly for Dolores' children, in Jesus' name.
Hold Praise the Lord. Pastor John, I have Carol from Laguna Vista, Texas, believing God for her house, paid in full, and help setting up her website. Well, right now, Carol, we're in agreement that your house will be paid in full. The Bible says, owe no man anything but to love him. So we're in agreement that you will owe no man anything but to love him. And whatever help you need, we're praying that God will give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation. Yes, Father, right now, I thank you for the spirit of wisdom and revelation for Carol to give her help, the help that she needs to effectively set up this website. I have Renee from Rochester believing God for eyesight restored for mom and dog. Well, you know what? This is the year of new vision. Praise the Lord. So we're believing for new vision in your eyesight for you and your dog in the name of Jesus. Marlene from South Carolina, healing from bladder cancer. Listen to me, Marlene, but bladder cancer is a name, and that name has to bow its knees to the name of Jesus. And the name of Jesus, we execute right now over this bladder cancer, and bladder cancer, we command you to get out of her body. Get out of her body right now. She is the healed, she is the redeemed, and she has been redeemed from the curse, and the curse includes all forms of cancer, and you are the blessed going somewhere to bless in
Amen.
Jesus' name.
Amen.
Carla from Los Angeles, believing God for no more pain in her right hip. Right now, just lay your hands on your right hip and say, Father, pain be gone in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Ernstine from St. Louis, believing God for healing for his nephew. He had a high blood pressure and depression, and he's in the hospital. Well, right now, Ernestine, we come into agreement, and Father,
yes,
I thank you for total and complete healing and restoration in his nephew right now. We come into agreement. I thank you that he does not have the spirit of fear, but he has the spirit of love and of power and of a sound mind. And Father, I thank you that those blood pressure numbers are going down and leveling out to where exactly how you designed them to be in Jesus' name.
Yes,
Pastor John.
Absolutely. You know, Holden, when you were praying, you prayed something that is so powerful. You prayed that the sickness, the cancer, whatever it is you were praying over, was a part of the curse.
Yeah.
And we've been redeemed from the curse. Your covenant with God has redeemed you from the curse.
Right.
And so it's important that you understand how powerful the covenant really is. That covenant includes every promise of God belonging to you, because God is a God of His Word. I want you to take a look at this. Brother Copeland talks about that very thing.
But we're joint heirs. How? By the blood. By the blood. The Almighty God, the El Shaddai God. That my covenant, as for me, my covenant is between me and thee. God chose to have covenant with us. Amen. And we had sense enough to accept it when we made Jesus the Lord of our lives. Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Praise God. You know, something I was thinking about that, I hear him say that, El Shaddai, the Almighty
Amen.
God, the way Brother Copeland says it, right? The Almighty
Amen.
God. And I'm thinking, you know, that's our God. You know, because
Praise
we have
God.
A big God, we can talk big, ain't
Amen.
That right?
Amen.
Amen.
We
Glory
can dream big. And Brother
we
Copeland
can.
Talks about that.
Yeah.
And this mini book that is the free product offer for you, just go to govictory.com/morningprayer and you can get this and make it available. Don't limit God. He is an almighty, He's an all-powerful God. Listen, you serve a God and you're the child of someone who hung the stars in the sky.
Amen.
And we want to try to think small? I don't think so.
Amen.
So dream big, talk big, and turn your faith loose. You know, Pastor Jones, exactly what we're doing right now.
That's
we're
right.
turning our faith loose.
That's absolutely right. And I'm holding in my hand prayer requests of several people who have called in praying for their family. There seems to be a running theme here, people calling in praying for family members. If you've got a family member that needs prayer, call that number, 877-281-6297. Call that number and we'll come into agreement with you concerning your family. And you have a covenant where your family is concerned, you and your house. I've said that so many times today. You and your house will be saved according
Amen.
To the word of God. Carolyn is praying for family healing for her cousin. Gloria is praying for her dad for cancer to go and for a complete recovery. Yolanda called in for prayer and got prayer for her healing for her son and for his family. Betty in Camden is praying for healing for her daughter's pregnancy and for a new home and freedom. Teresa in Wallace, Virginia is praying for her husband's knees. So many people are praying for family members this morning. So let me come into agreement with you right now. And again, if you've got a family member that needs prayer, call that number, 877-281-6297. Father, right now for family members, for fathers, for mothers,
Thank
for
you,
daughters,
Jesus.
For sons, God, for healings, for pregnancies, God, for knees, for cancer to go out of family members. Lord, right now we come into agreement with those who are watching us, who are putting a stake in the ground and saying, not my family, not
Amen.
My family. We plead the blood of Jesus over their children. God, we plead the blood of Jesus over their extended family. Father, we thank you that you promised us not just ourselves, but our family
yes, Jesus.
Would be saved. And so, Lord, we step into that covenant with you right now in the name
in the
of
name.
Jesus. Tim, I want to get you involved here. I know that you've got some prayer requests coming in over there. What's going on?
I do, John. You know, yesterday as I was hosting Victory Update, this rose up on the inside of me to share with people, and I think it would be really good to share this now. In the Bible, it says, let not your heart be troubled. You know, it doesn't do you any good to wring your hands about what's going on around the country, around the world, or even in your own life. You know, sometimes it can be a little intimidating and it can be really big in your own eyes, but you know what? It's not that big for God. It's not too big for Him. And the Bible just says, let not your heart be troubled. Just trust God. Just take a time to just step back and say, God, I trust you. I love you. I trust you. And let us help you. Call 877-281-6297 and let us agree with you. That's what we are here to do. We're here to add a little extra support to whatever it is you're believing God for, because you know what? You can make it. You're going to make it, and you're the winner. You're the head and not the tail, You're above and not beneath. Just like Kathleen, who called in, complete healing for her loved one. Kathleen, your loved one is healed in Jesus' name. Stephanie called in, healing, salvation for her family. We are in agreement with you, Stephanie. Judy called in, healing for the president and his family. We've already prayed for that, but I know all of us are continuing to pray and agree that they have a complete and quick and speedy recovery in Jesus' name. Judith called in, supernatural debt cancellation, peace and healing for our land. And Judith, we appreciate that, and we're agreeing with you for your debt cancellation. Mark, finances to pay rent and a new job. Mark, God's got that handled. God can take care of that. And just all you need to do is let not your heart be troubled and trust God that He will take care of you. And then I have this testimony from Renee. When Victory Thon was on last week, she said, Lord, I want to give $1,000. And the Lord blessed her with $1,000 to give today. She said it was supernatural, and she is so excited to give to Victory Thon. That can be your testimony too. Pastor John?
Amen. Amen. You're absolutely right. You know what, Tim? I was just having such a good time listening to you talking about not letting your heart be troubled, because you're absolutely right. The Holy Ghost is our comforter. That's His job. He comforts us. Willie in New Orleans, I want to remind you, you have a comforter where healing and finances are concerned. Joan in Georgia is praying for diabetes and for finances. I want to remind you that the comforter is working on your behalf. You're being healed in your body, and those finances are coming because He supplies all of your needs according to His riches and glory by Christ Jesus. And Carol in Pensacola is praying for peace and comfort. Let me tell you something. The Comforter, the one that Jesus sent, is coming to comfort you. He's already come. All you have to do is receive Him right now. So, Father, right now we receive the Holy Spirit. We receive the ministry of the Holy Ghost. God, I thank you that what Jesus promised concerning the Holy Spirit, that He would guide us and lead us into all truth, teach us all things, show us all things, and bring all things to our remembrance. Father, that that ministry is active in our lives today. The ministry of the Holy Spirit is active in our lives today, and we receive Him by faith in Jesus' name. Amen. 877-281-6297. Call that number. We got just a few more minutes in the program, and if you don't get through, keep calling back. Keep persisting, and let these licensed prayer ministers come into agreement with you concerning whatever it is that you need. Holden, what's going on over there? I see you with a hand of paper.
I got a hand. You know, there's an anointing for healing.
And they keep coming. Look at this.
Amen. There's an anointing for healing today, Pastor John. Here's Kristen from Pennsylvania, believing God for healing from brain disease, Alzheimer's, and memory loss. Well, Kristen, right now, I want to remind you what the Bible says. The Bible says that you have the mind of Christ. So, Father, right now I come into agreement with my sister Kristen, and we lay hold of that promise that is set and fixed, that we have the mind of Christ. And the mind of Christ has no memory loss. The mind of Christ has no Alzheimer's. The mind of Christ has no brain disease. And I thank you for that manifestation of that mind, of the anointed one and His anointing, the burden-removing, yoke-destroying power of God manifesting in her mind and in her brain right now in the name of Jesus. Here's Ruben from Indio, believing God from healing from sciatica issues in his body and for financial breakthrough. Well, the Bible says, Ruben, that He meets your needs. That's healing, that's financially, that's socially, that's your family,
that's
your relationships, that's everything. He meets every single one of your needs according to His riches and glory, which has no issues, which has no financial lack. So right now we're believing for His glory to manifest in your life. Here's Dolores from Riverside, believing God for healing for her husband's kidney. Father, right now we lift this up to you, and I thank you that his kidneys are operating exactly how they're designed to operate. Father, I thank you so much that they do exactly what they're designed to do in Jesus' name. And Dolores, I want to hear the testimony. You guys call and share with us your testimonies. This is the same number, 877-281-6297. Mm-hmm. When you call in and pray, be believing God and expecting, because the Bible says when two or more come into agreement as touching anything, our point of contact. We're touching this. Yeah. We are on the earth touching this as a point of contact. And the Bible says that when we do that, the I Am shows up. And when the I Am shows up, answers always come.
That's absolutely right. Deborah in Lincoln, is praying for deliverance and healing for her family. Esther is praying for protection and healing for her granddaughter from COVID. Karen is praying for healing and health for COVID-19 in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Perfecta is praying for healing for a loved one. And Patricia in Fairburn is praying for healing in her back and her chest and for her son to come back to the Lord. Father, right now, as Holden said, I come into agreement with that, yeah. Lord. As Holden said, there's an anointing for healing on this program. Amen. And so, Father, we release the healing power of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we stand on everything that Jesus did on the cross. We take it Thank for ourselves. You, Father, we receive it in the name of Jesus, and we give you glory for it. We thank you, Father, for healing within the body of Christ. In Jesus' name. Now, we've got just under 5 minutes to go. Tim, I want to get you involved one more time before we go off the program today.
All right, John, I do have a few. It's Yolanda called in on behalf of her neighbor who needs healing and finances. And you've already heard John and Holden and all of us talk about the fact that there's an anointing on this today. There's an anointing on this program. So we're in agreement with you, Yolanda, for your neighbor. Ernestine, protection for her daughter who's on a trip and debt freedom for her. Ernestine, God's got you covered. Julia needs healing. Julia's healed in Jesus' name. Lessie, mom needs healing for her kidneys. So we believe God with you that your mom's kidneys clear up and they're whole and well in Jesus' name. And then Janelle called in deliverance from spiritual warfare. Janelle, just remember, and remember all of us, this is a good reminder, we have a covenant with the Almighty God who is greater. There is none greater than Him. So whatever you're dealing with, whether it's spiritual warfare or sickness or disease or anxiety, God is bigger than that. Pastor John.
Glory to God. Hey, Tim, come on back over here. We're going to pray over these and lay our hands over on these as we get ready to go off the program this morning. I just want to get to a few of these. This one came in. Janet in Kentucky is praying over her son. He's going to be racing his motorcycle this weekend. So apparently he's going to be competing in some way. Father, right now, I pray over Janet's son. And God, I pray that you would wrap your arms around him. Protecting angels, ministering spirits, you go now and protect him as he's racing that motorcycle. And Father, we say that no hurt, harm, danger, or calamity will come upon him right now in the name of Jesus. Marilyn in Harvard is praying for her house to sell. Father, I pray that you would send the right buyer, the right person across across her path to purchase that home. Willie is praying for debt freedom and a job. Willie, I thank you, Lord, that you are sending Willie the right job, the perfect assignment. We pray it every Sunday for the perfect assignment. And I come into agreement with Willie right now for a perfect assignment and for freedom from debt in the name of Jesus. And Elizabeth in Oklahoma is praying for favor for her son in a court case. Father, right now, I thank you for the favor of God, the favor of God on her son in that court case in Jesus' name. Tim, come on in Amen. Here. I want to remind you, Victory Update is today at 5 p.m. Eastern, 4 Central. Also, this coming Sunday, EMIC services. There are two services for you to join us for, 10 a.m. Eastern and 12 p.m. Eastern. That's 9 a.m. Central Time and 11 a.m. Central Time. And if you're in the Fort Worth area, we want you to come and be a part in person. Also, on our midweek service on Wednesday, 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 p.m. Central. Again, if you're anywhere in the Fort Worth Metroplex, we want you to come. We have something for the entire family. Children's services, youth services, wherever you are, we want you to come and be a part. Nice. And America Stands, a very special edition of America Stands on Wednesday. That's the 7th Wednesday, the vice presidential debate at 9 p.m. Eastern, 8 p.m. Central. Glory to God, gentlemen.
Amen.
The desk is filling up.
Yes. It is.
And the calls yes. continue to come in. We're going to yes. get these in over here.
Praise
We've got
God.
Got some still coming in. Let's lay our hands on these and agree.
Absolutely.
Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for the healing power of God, for the delivering power of God, for setting these people free in the name of Jesus. God, we give you glory and honor and praise. God, we praise you for the testimony. Father, we praise you for the testimony of debt freedom and debt cancellation. We praise you, God, for the testimony in their bodies, Father, of pain being released, according to the Word of God, that every promise in the Word of God belongs to us. And so right now, by faith, we take hold of those promises in Jesus' mighty name.